138 reading for understanding. Reading for understanding. Number one, explain the plan that was in Spider's mind when he said of the spotted bush fowl, I expect she'll soon be telling her friends that it was not I who gave her the delicate spotted plumage. Now, students, you have to tell me what was in the mind of the spider. What was his plan? Raise your hand. What was his plan? Yes, Momin. What was his plan?
Teacher, his plan was to eat his food.
No, what was the spider's plan? How to take revenge on the lion? Yesterday I told you, you have to mark the answers. Ji, who will tell me? Nurul Iman.
Just as the lion swallowed the last of spider's tasty fish, the beautifully spotted bush fowl scuttled past, and spider very cleverly saw a way of getting his revenge on the greedy and arrogant lion.
Okay, beta, who else? Ahmed Raza, you tell me.
The spider made the lion fool.
Then, basically, you have to tell okay, what was the plan in his mind. Okay, when he said that, I expect she'll soon be telling her friend that it was not I who gave her the delicate spotted plumage. His plan was to tie the
lion with a kazura tree and then
take
his revenge.
Correct. His plan was to deceive the lion by making him believe that the spider was the one who gave the delicate spotted plumage to the bush fowl. So he wanted the lion to be tied with the kazura tree so that he could punish him for eating his fish. Okay, that is the answer. Question number two. Ahmed Raza, you need to keep your cameras on, all the boys. And it will not be told again and again. Otherwise, you will be marked absent. What did Spider tell the lion he had to do in order for Spider to give him a spotted skin? Which two things did the spider ask the lion to do? Which two things? Yes, Rohan.
The spider asked the lion that he wanted a bush cow and a kazura tree.
Kazura tree, correct.
What is the meaning of kazura tree?
It's a tree. They have given a name. It's a name given. There's no such kazura tree. Okay? It's just a name given. Okay. So the spider said to the lion that he wanted two things, a big bush cow and a well-grown kazura tree. Okay, that is the answer. Question number three. What did the lion make out of the bush cow's skin when he ripped it with his claws? What did he make out of the bush cow's skin? What did he make out of the bush cow skin? It's very easy answer. Rayan.
He turned it into a strips like pieces of rope.
Very good. He made strips like pieces of rope. That is the answer. He made the strips of the hide of the skin just like the pieces of rope. Good. Next question. How did the spider encourage the lion to do the things which he told him to do? How did the spider encourage the lion? What did he keep saying? Riyan, you have done. I want the other students, girls. G. Umar Nawaz, you tell me. What did he keep saying? Yes, Umar Nawaz. What did the spider say to the lion to encourage the lion? How did he encourage the lion? You need to unmute your mic. Speak up. Yes, Umar.
Hello.
Yes, Umar. Yesterday, I told you, you have to mark the answers, you have to write down the answers. Yes, Priyan.
The class yesterday.
He keep telling the lion, the spider keep telling the lion that he gives the bush
foul.
He
get
bush foul the dotted skin,
and he said to the lion that he would look far more handsomer than the bush foul. Okay, he said to the lion that you would look far more handsomer than the bush fowl. It's written over here, na? Page number 136. You will say that he said that you have made a neat job of that. I should think that your spots will be far handsomer than the bush fowl. So he encouraged the lion by telling him that his spots would be far handsomer than the bush fowls. Will is changed into would because you have to write the answer in past tense. Okay? Now, next question. How did spider give the lion his spotted skin? How did spider give the lion his spotted skin? G. Raise your hand. Only Rohan and Rayan are answering. I want other students. What about Fatma Quddus? Yes, Fatma Quddus or Fatma Hassan? Beta, you need to unmute your mic when I'm asking you an answer. How many times I'm going to say this thing? You need to participate in the class. It's not like you keep your mics muted. Yes, Ahmed.
The spider gave the lion spotted skin. The spider gave the lion his spotted skin by putting a number of metal skewers into the fire, and as soon as one became red hot, he seized it and plunged it into the poor lion's skin.
Good. The spider put a number of metal skewers into the fire, and as soon as one became red hot, he seized it and plunged it into the poor lion's skin. So how he gave the lion his spotted skin? By plunging the hot metal skewers into the body of the lion. Good, Ahmed. Ahmed Raza, you need to keep your camera on, otherwise you will be marked absent. Next question. Last question. How did the lion react when he realized that spider was not going to untie him? How did the lion react? Last paragraph. How did the lion react? Peter, you need to fix them, both of you. Faisal, you also? And Ahmed Raza, you also, okay? Chale. Yes. How did the lion react? The last answer? Yes, Nurul Iman. Yes, Nurul Iman, last answer. Yes, Pita, hurry up. How did the lion react at the end? How did the lion react at the end?
The lion. The foolish lion lay down and spider.
No, no, no. Spider. In the end. In the end. At the end of the story.
The poor lion was frantic, but no amount of twisting and turning could undo this bound bone. And
The poor lion was frantic, but no amount of twisting and turning could undo his bonds. The spider was not going to untie the poor lion. He was frantic, he behaved wildly, but he couldn't do anything. Okay? Yeah? Okay. So we have done the question answers. Now, students, we are going to start grammar word. Today we will only discuss it, inshallah. On Monday we will do the exercise. Okay, this chapter is completed, spider and the lion. Question answers, you will write down the summary only in homework. Summary, okay? Meanings and question answers I will send you, okay? Now, okay, Ahmed, okay. Now, Bitta, we have to start unit number 5. Don't open your grammar books. Right now, we are just discussing. Now, what are articles? One article is the article which we write in the newspaper, in the magazine, something written. Okay? These articles are the articles which qualify now. There are 3 articles. A, an, and the. What are the 3 articles? A, an, and the. Okay, these are the 3 articles. At the end, Rohan, let me explain the articles. Students, you know that the alphabets are divided into 2 parts. Vowels and consonants. Vowels and consonants. Vowels are only 5. A, E, I, O, U. Like 5 fingers. Count on your 5 fingers. A, E, I, O, U. These are the vowels. And we put and with them. A, E, I, O, U. Okay? These are 5 in number. And all the other remaining alphabets are called consonants. B, C, D, F, G, H, and so on. Okay? Now, student, indefinite articles. Please keep your notebooks with you, your pencils with you, so that if there's anything important, you can write down in your notebooks. Now, students, I've told you there are 3 articles, a, an, and the. A and an are called the indefinite articles, okay? Because you can put them with anyone, okay? Like a book, a copy, an egg, an umbrella. A house, a pillow, a copy, a pencil, an eraser, and igloo, things like that. Okay? So, a and an are called indefinite articles. What are the indefinite articles? A and an are called indefinite articles. And we put them before a singular countable noun. Singular countable nouns. Remember one thing. We never put a or an before uncountable nouns. We always put a or an before singular countable nouns. Like one, a book. I have a book. He has a copy. She has a pencil. He has got an umbrella. So a is put before nouns beginning with a consonant sound. And is put before nouns beginning with a vowel sound. Okay, so vowel sound is also important. Like if I'm saying H-O-U-R, we do not pronounce it as har. We are going to pronounce it as our. So the sound is of O and U. And these are vowels. So we are going to write an hour. I'm going to complete my work in an hour. Okay, students. Now you can see an is put before nouns beginning with a vowel sound. And a is put before nouns beginning with a consonant sound. There is a shirt of red color in my cupboard. Sh sound. I boiled an egg. E vowel. An ant and a grasshopper went for a walk. G consonant. A and. Sarah wants a new story. N. Okay. So remember one thing, that we put indefinite articles are an, and we put them before one, because obviously an refers to one. We never say our books, our copies, our pencils. We never say like that. We say a book, a copy, a pencil, a notebook, an egg, an umbrella. Okay? Things like that. Okay. Definite article. I want all of you to please read this chapter number 5. Okay? Chapter number 5, your grammar book. So that on Monday, inshallah, we will do it. I will again explain these concepts and we will do the exercises also. Okay, don't do the exercise, just read it. Now students, definite means, when the word definite comes, it means some particular, some specific. So the is called the definite article. The is called the definite article. Okay, a and an are called the indefinite articles. If in the exam I ask you, indefinite articles are dash, so you will write a and an. And I'll write, tell you, definite article is dash, you are going to write the, okay? So, the is a definite article because we put the before some specific noun. If we want to specify some noun, we put the. For example, once upon a time, there lived a man. Can be any man, we don't know. Once upon a time, there lived a man in a village. It can be any village. So we have put a indefinite article. Full stop. The man. Now we have written the man. In the second sentence, we will not write a man, because we are now talking about the specific man. That specific man we are talking about. The man was kind and generous with his friends and all the other villagers. The village was near to the woods. Now students, you see, in the first sentence I've said once upon a time there lived a man in a village. Because we don't know the man, we don't know the village. It can be any man, it can be any village. Now if I'm telling about that particular man, I'm going to put the man. Now we are talking about the same man. For example, if you say there is a boy in my class, there is a boy. He can be any boy. He can be Rayan, he can be Ahmed, he can be Rohan, he can be any. The boy is very naughty. Now you are telling about that particular boy. The boy is very intelligent. You understand? So we put the when we want to specify a noun. Rohan, I don't know beta. Yes. Ask.
Yes. I want to add that we will do summary and question answers of these chapter.
You will do the summary only. Summary, okay?
And teacher?
Yes.
Teacher, the behind chapters, I have done some of the work by myself because you haven't sent the notes. It's okay,
Rohan, listen. I will send and you can just check them out. If there's any big mistake, then you can change it.
You have changed, but when you have given us the notes before 1 or 2 days, I have done these question answers.
So I understand. Okay? It's so. No problem. Okay, now shall I continue?
Yes, please.
So, beta, one thing I've told you, the is called the definite article and we put the before some particular noun. If we want to specify one particular noun. The other nouns before which we put the, it is put before some proper nouns, not all proper nouns. Like names of rivers, oceans, seas, islands, deserts, some books, titles of the books, okay? Then we put the before the superlative degree of adjective. Superlative degree, tallest, highest, strongest, thickest, laziest, the most intelligent. So we have to put the before the superlative degree. He is the best student of my class. She is the most intelligent girl in our family. Okay, so I'm putting the before superlative degree of adjective. Before the superlative degree of adjective. Okay? He is the tallest boy of our school. Okay? In this way. Lahore is the most fertile city of Pakistan. Okay? You can say Karachi is the biggest city of Pakistan. So you have to put the with the superlative degree of adjective. Now we put the before ordinal numbers. Ordinal numbers are like first, second, third, fourth. He stood. He's